A lot to talk about today in the aftermath of Iowa. Governor Christie coming in 10th out of 12. That's not good. If you're running Governor Christie's campaign for president, it's even worse. And now the governor heads to New Hampshire. So the question that I asked was, what happens here? You've got a governor that has about a 30% approval rating, you know, give or take, depending on the poll. By all accounts, not popular, and two-thirds of the state upset because he's been campaigning for president. Now, maybe that would have changed if he had come back for the storm. I mean, there are all kinds of speculation, hindsight. You know, you get perfect vision with that. What I ask is, what happens next? I'd like to see Governor Christie after New Hampshire come back to New Jersey and join us on our digging in list. You know, Lieutenant Governor's on that list. Joe Piscopo's on that list. We're digging in to solve the problems that are here because the problems are many. They total almost $200 billion when you talk about unfunded future liabilities on pensions and benefits, when you talk about the massive state debt, almost $100 billion, and there doesn't seem to be any solution in sight. And before we start compromising on raising taxes, which to me is outrageous and unnecessary, I want to know who's going to have the courage to sit down and make some dramatic changes and call these politicians out. I'm joined by Assembly Republican Leader Jon Bramnick. John, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Oh, great. Thanks for having me, Bill. I appreciate it.
You bet. So, John, you're in the thick of it. You know, the Assembly, I realize that Republicans are the minority party in both houses, but clearly there's a message that can be led by the minority party to help fix the state. So two questions to you. One, what is the plan for the future of New Jersey? And two, what do you expect and what do you hope the governor to do following New Hampshire?
Sure. Yeah, there is a lot of attention on Chris Christie. But if we look at the legislature itself, and that's Vinny Prieto and President Sweeney, there are a lot of options, but they're painful options. You talked about pension reform. Mm-hmm. You know, there's already a bipartisan committee that says, hey, here's what we have to do to the future. That's never been presented to the legislature for a vote. School funding is fundamentally unfair. It's run by a Supreme Court formula. You know, unless the legislature takes on, and that's about almost half of the budget, would go to pension and to school funding. So unless you take on that $15 billion debt or responsibility, you really can't get to the problems of the state being unaffordable. So some of the focus has to get on the legislature and the majority party and say, what proposals are you going to vote on? What proposal are you going to pass to lower the cost of living in the state? That's the question. And they escape some responsibility because of the focus on Chris Christie.
So what specifically do you tell them? I mean, I know they're, you know, because I'm an advocate against the gas tax, and I'll be talking later in the week and maybe even next week with the folks at AAA, which I know they're not opposed to it. To me, that seems almost irrelevant to talk about, you know, a couple million bucks here and there when we're talking about hundreds of billions of dollars and a state budget that, correct me if I'm wrong, is somewhere around $30 billion. And or $32 billion, and we take in about $29 or $30 billion. So we're running behind every year as it is, right?
Sure, sure. So if you don't address the unfair school funding formula and this so-called in looking at putting $5 to $7 billion into pensions, we're going to have to make reforms in both of these areas where you will never solve the problem. But and at least discuss it on the floor of the legislature. When you say digging in, you know, let's call upon the president of the Senate and the speaker to say, let's have an open discussion on the floor of the legislature on the big spending items and what we're going to do about it. Otherwise, what happens is they're really good at focusing on, you know, on Chris Christie, and I don't like him, but let's put the tough issues on the table. Let's vote on them up and down.
Let's talk about it. Give me one, and I'm going to start talking about it. What's the one thing in school funding? How do you change that to make it more fair and bring this cost down?
Instead of having a formula, which the Supreme Court has set, we have to challenge this Supreme Court decision, which started with Abbott. And we have to say the following. All schools are entitled to some funding and some reasonable funding. And you have to find out, you have to send in teams into the areas that are using this money to determine whether it's being used efficiently. Otherwise, we will continue to throw money down a rat hole. We need to continue. We need to find out where the waste is, where the success is, and there is absolutely no plan in that regard. That's one. And two, We've got to figure out how to change that pension. Follow the bipartisan committee rules. Put that in front of the legislature.
Yeah, okay. You know what, John? They sound reasonable. I hope that this dialogue will start. I think the governor has an opportunity to lead this discussion and bring everyone together. I'd like to see the governor bring you and Vinny Prieto together to have a conversation about it and stop all the politicking about whether or not we are anti-teacher or anti-union, because all those are throwaway political sound bites. And the reality is New Jersey's too expensive for the average person to live here and stay here. I know you're digging in. Can I add you to the list? I'm assuming you're digging in.
Please. And Bill, thanks for raising these issues, because unless we talk about them in an open forum, they're never going to be heard.
I hear you. All right, John, I'm adding you to the digging in list. You're in good company. Joe Piscopo, Kim Guadagno, it's all good. We're gonna save this state, John.
And Joe's a funny guy, so he can bring some humor to the table.
There you go. All right. That's Jon Bramnick. John, thanks for calling me on New Jersey 101.5. He is the Assembly Republican leader and a stand-up comic. So we'll be hearing more from John, as the year moves on and they start discussing real issues. Imagine that.